السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. آمين يا رب العالمين. We're starting from Ayah 86 in Surah Imran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَيْفَ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا كَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ وَشَهِدُوا أَنَّ الرَّسُولَ حَقٌّ وَجَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. Ibn Jarir, he records from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu that these ayat, so starting from Ayah 86 all the way through to the end of the page until Ayah 91, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he says, these ayat were revealed upon the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because of an Ansari man, a man from the Ansar, right, who had left Islam. He had accepted Islam, and then he left Islam, and then later on he realized his mistake and he wanted to join Islam again. Right, he realized his mistake and he wanted to come back and join Islam again. And so he sent some men to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to inquire about, you know, what he was trying to do, basically, about trying to come back to Islam again. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these ayat, and the men took this back to the Ansari person, and he accepted Islam once again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَيْفَ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ كَيْفَ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ. How does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide, يعني how do you expect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide, قَوْمًا, people, كَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ, they had rejected the sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after they had tasted iman. وَشَهِدُوا, and they witnessed أَنَّ الرَّسُولَ حَقٌّ, they witnessed that the messenger is true. They witnessed that this is a true messenger, right? وَجَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ, and clear signs have come to these people. وَاللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَا يَهْدِي, he does not guide الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ, the people who are wrongdoers. أُولَٰئِكَ, those people, جَزَاؤُهُمْ, their recompense, their reward, if you want to say, is anna alayhim, that upon them will be la'natullahi, the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal malaikati, and the curse of his angels, wal nasi ajma'in, and the curse of all the people, khalidin fiha, these people will stay in and abide in forever the hellfire, la yukhaffafu, it will not be lightened anhum upon them, al adhabu, the punishment, walahum yunzarun, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at them, yani he does not look at them with the eye of mercy, all right, illa alladhina tabu, except for those people who tabu, turned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, min ba'di dhalika, after what they had did, right, while you're still within that window of tawbah, right, if you turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, min ba'di dhalika, after their error that they made, wa aslahu, and they corrected their mistakes, they corrected themselves. And in this ayah here, we see the condition for tawbah, right? It is not that you just return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, oh Allah, forgive me, I can't stop what I'm doing just yet, but oh Allah, if I die, go ahead and forgive me, please. It doesn't work like that. Tawbah has conditions. And the main conditions are to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask for His forgiveness, and to let go and correct that mistake that you are doing. Right? So, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ وَأَصْلَحُوا. These are the main conditions for tawbah. Right? فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ, then indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is غَفُورٌ, the one who is forgiving, رَحِيمٌ, and the one who is very merciful. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, indeed those who reject the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ, after they have embraced the iman, ثُمَّ afterwards, ازْدَادُوا كُفْرًا, they had increased only in this rejection, they have increased only in this kufr, right? لَن تُقْبَلَ تَوْبَتْهُمْ, their tawbah will not be accepted, وَأُولَٰئِكَ, and those people, هُمْ الضَّالُونَ, are the ones who have gone astray. Right, and this doesn't mean, right, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't accept tawbah at all. It means that within that window of opportunity of making tawbah, if this person does not make tawbah, and izdadu kufra, they've only increased in this kufr, right? They've only increased in rejecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's message, and increased in rejecting the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In that case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept tawbah once a person has died, or once the time for a person to die has come. What did Fir'aun say? Fir'aun said after he realized that he was, you know, about to drown, حَتَّى إِذَا أَدْرَكَهُ الْغَرَقُ, until the water, You know, he was drowning. He knew his life was over. He knew his time was done. He said, "Amantu annahu la ilaha illa alladhi amanat bihi banu Israel." Right? At that point, when he knew he had no way out of this, he knew he couldn't swim out of this water, he knew there was nothing he could do, he said, "I believe in this God, right? I believe that there is no God except the God that these Banu Israel people are believing in." Right? And so at that point, there is no Tawbah accepted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Tawbah, وَلَيْسَتِ التَّوْبَةُ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Tawbah is not for those who commit sins, right? حَتَّى إِذَا حَضَرَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ. Until the time for death has come for them. Right? So all your life, the window of Tawbah is open. The opportunity for Tawbah is open. Once the time for your death has come, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has closed those doors and it's done. Any mistake someone can make while they are alive, even shirk, the greatest of mistakes that someone can make, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive as long as you use your window of opportunity. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, those who have disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and rejected His message, وَمَاتُوا, and they died, وَهُمْ كُفَّارٌ, while they died, while they are in this state of kufr, right? فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ, it will not be accepted مِنْ أَحَدِهِمْ, from any one of them, مِلْءُ الْأَرْضِ, the capacity of this earth filled with ذَهَبًا, gold, وَلَوْ افْتَدَى بِهِ, if they try to use it as ransom for forgiveness, right? If they filled the capacity of this earth, all that is within this earth, right? If they filled it with gold, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept it from them as ransom. Ulaika, those people, lahum adhabun alim, they have a very painful punishment. Wa ma lahum, and for them will not be min nasirina, anyone to help them. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who realize their mistakes and perform the tawbah while we still have the opportunity and the chance. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers, I want you 2 minutes time to make some important announcements. We have 15 brothers and sisters made the committee of ICNBM, Islamic Center of Nashville, Bellevue Mosque. And alhamdulillah, we are meeting frequently, and we have laws, bylaws, we have a system in place. So we made decisions recently, but we were waiting to make the announcement formally, send emails to everyone. But that takes some time. We want to make it perfect. Now, since there's a need for us to let you know those decisions. And when I am speaking, don't think that I'm one person speaking. We are 15 brothers and sisters, unanimously make decisions, and we are 15 people talking. It's not only me. So number one, about the leading salat. We have sheikh, we have imam, so he leads salat, no question about that. But in case when Sheikh Omar is not here, then we have several brothers in line to lead the salat. No one else is allowed to come and lead the salat. If Sheikh Omar is not here, then Dr. Junaid, who is a hafiz, you know him all, right? He will lead the salat. And he is not here. Then Dr. Isam, who is a scholar, you know Professor Isam, he will lead the salat. Since he is not coming these days, the board told me to lead the salat. Of course, I never push myself to do this heavy job, but because people want, I don't know, I hope that everybody agrees. And then committee told me to do that, so I do that. If I'm not here, then there are other brothers in line to do that. The bottom line is, no one can come and lead the salat without the approval of the ICNBM EC. That's number one. And number two, we have several decisions, but I'm not going to say all. I already discussed with Brother Munir, our president, and he told me to make these announcements. The second thing is, this is a mosque run by an organization. This is not something that, like, anybody can come and talk. In order to come and talk here, someone needs an approval from their committee. And imam is not the person to get the approval from. So if someone asks imam to talk, that is not an approval. So I request Sheikh Omar, if he's here, or Brother Jimmy, or someone, read the hadith or give a talk. If someone asks permission, tell them that, no, I am asked to talk. So these two things I'm telling, there are more coming, inshallah, stay tuned. And hopefully we will, if someone comes and try to bully, if someone comes to, you know, disrespect our rules, we have to be strongly, unanimously, all should speak in one voice, that no, there are rules and bylaws, we have to follow that, inshallah. So we'll make this announcement tomorrow morning also, inshallah, and in the Jummah and in the coming days. And you will see email, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Thank you.